I'm going to show you how we can recover an unsaved drawing file. So in this project that I was working on, I had some 2D drawings going, and unfortunately, Toolbox crashed on me, and I didn't get a chance to save beforehand. So when that happens, we do have the option to recover that drawing by going into AutoCAD and use the Drawing Recovery Manager. So take notes, and I'll show you what we can do to get our drawing back to where we were before the drawing closed. All right, let's get into it. Now, everything was working just fine, putting together some of these 2D drawings. But as I started to get a little bit more into it and drawing that dynamic image, a lot of resources were being used. And unfortunately, that's when AutoCAD decided it needed to close. Now, luckily, we have a couple things set up for us that prevents us from losing this work. One of them is the autosave. So as long as you have your autosave set up, you could go back to that location and use that file. Or the other way to do it is let AutoCAD recover that drawing for you. So when this does happen, just make sure you select yes so Toolbox can attempt to save those changes. And now let's get into the process of recovering that drawing. Once you get Toolbox started back up, you'll notice the Drawing Recovery Manager palette is docked on your screen. We'll just drag that out so we can see what's going on there, expand the folder to the most recent drawing. And if Toolbox was able to save some of those changes, you'll see a recover.dwg file. Now, if for whatever reason, that Drawing Recovery Manager palette did not dock, you can go into the File tab in your ribbon and down to Drawing Utilities and open up the Drawing Recovery Manager that way. Now we also have that autosave file in that same folder. Now, either one that you select, you're going to have to rename. So whether it's this autosave file or the recovering drawing file, you're going to have to open it up, save it as a new name, so it becomes the room inside of your Toolbox project. Now just let AutoCAD do its thing in the background as it recovers the drawing. And now that we have this recovered drawing open, we'll go into the File tab and save it back to our Common Microvellum Data folder under that project. My shop DWG is the one that Toolbox looks to when we open that room through the Microvellum palette. And just overwrite that existing. Now at this point, we haven't opened up a project in Toolbox yet. So now it's time to do that. Under the Microvellum palette, go into the projects, open up that project we were working on. And because we saved that recovered drawing back with that name, when we open this room, we have access to not only the drawing, but of course, all the data inside of it. Now here's a little thing to look out for when this does happen. Typically, it'll only occur on 2D drawings because it was an AutoCAD related issue. So if you're trying to redraw a product and you get this error, it's coming in from the 2D drawing objects. Now we're able to delete this in AutoCAD because it's not related to the actual Microvellum product. It's just a 2D representation of it. So with AutoCAD, delete those 2D objects that are coming in from that product that you're trying to redraw. Now I want to bring back this dynamic image that I had in the drawing, but you'll notice if I select the 2D elevation drawing of that product, it's also not linked to the actual Microvellum product. So some of the data got corrupt inside of this drawing, and the way to fix this is, like I said, delete some of those 2D drawings that are coming in from that specific product. So draw a window around that 2D elevation, and we'll delete that as well. Use the redraw 2D walls command, and it'll bring back the 2D elevations that were associated to that Microvellum wall. And one last thing that you can do if you're still getting some results that you aren't quite expecting is go into the product viewer and redraw that selected product from database. Now we can get this drawing back to the way that it was looking before. So as long as you follow those steps and Toolbox was able to save those changes before it crashed, then you should be able to get that drawing back and not lose much work at all. Now, luckily this doesn't happen too much, but just remember to always have your autosave turned on. And now if it does, at least know what to do when you need to recover that drawing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time in another training lesson, Microvellum University.